हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड, आई होप यू आर डूइंग ग्रेट। वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। इफ़ यू हैव नॉट सब्सक्राइब इट, प्लीज सब्सक्राइब इट, प्रेस द बेल आइकन, हिट द लाइक बटन आल्सो। फ्रेंड्स, एज यू नो, वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड अप टू आर्टिकल 24। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आर्टिकल 25। इट प्लेज अ वेरी सिग्निफिकेंट रोल फॉर योर प्रिपरेशन। प्लीज लिसन एंड हियर द ऑल थिंग्स वट एवर आई एम टेलिंग हियर मेटिकुलसली, अदरवाइज यू विल lag behind the other aspirant who are reading and who are hearing meticulously. Please pay attention. Now let me start the article 25. Right to freedom of religion means right to freedom of religion. It is showing that each and every person, and this fundamental right is available to the Indians and the foreigner also, means whatever, whoever citizen would be there, then it is having right to freedom of religion in India. If a person is coming from the foreign on the soil of the India, then he would be like eligible to get such type of right in India. And Article 25th clause 1 is saying that the subjected to public order, morality and health, to other provision of this part, all persons are equally entitled to freedom of conscience. Here the explicitly is mentioning there that freedom of conscience. Freedom of conscience means you are having your conscience, means you are having your mind. You have make your mind that yes, I would have faith any such type of religion, or each and every person have different perception about the religion and the philosophy, then they would pursue as per their conscience. That it is the absolute fundamental right, means there is no exception. People are having conscience and they can choose their religion as per their conscience. But the second part of this article is saying that right to freely profess, practice and propagate. Profess, practice and propagate is an outward form. Outward form means it's come up with the certain reasonable restriction also. Yes, each and every person have their conscience and they can choose their religion according to their choice. But freely to profess means each and every person can profess any religion in which he is thinking that they are following the good philosophy, and he can choose. Practice means he can chant the tenets of that religion. It totally depends on the person mentality in which he is able to support, then he can pursue or practice that religion. But propagation is something like a tricky thing. Propagate means if I will take example of the 1977 case, that Reverend Stephen Father Stanislaw. Father Stanislaw case was there versus like state of MP in the 1977, in which that conversion, the Father Stanislaw filed a case in the MP, and like in that case that father was telling that conversion to the another people is also the essential practice of the, or the like having rights under Article 25, but court declared this unconstitutional. Yes, each and every person have their conscience and they can profess and practice any religion, but propagation doesn't mean that conversion. If a person is converting the people in the form of the inducement, you are invoking or inciting any person to adopt any culture or leaving their religion, that is not good and that is not valid as per the Article 25. If this happening is under threat, or this is happening under coercion or the bribe, then it is a not healthy practice and it can be like a revert back to the society. Because you might have seen or heard in the newspaper, like so many cases are coming that if a Christian community giving rupees to the, or they are like giving allurement to the poor people to join their religion, and that is like very detrimental for the harmony of the society and our religion. Because India is a secular country and we are not following such type of practice, and even this is not allowed in the Article 25 clause 1 also. Article 25 clause 2 is that nothing is this article shall affect the operation of an existing law and prevent state of the making any law. Means whatever that in this article is mentioning, would not stop any like state government, means state means Indian government, to follow any or make law. If you talk about the like a restriction on the base of the public order or morality, means there can be restriction on the propagation of the religion on the basis of the morality and public order. If like if you are converting people from one religion to another religion in the avenge of the like allurement, you are giving money or you are like threatening anyone else, you are putting pressure on him to convert his religion from that, that is not a healthy practice and that can be restricted by the our sorry for that. And that is not valid in India. Even like on the basis of the public order and morality, government can put restriction also. If you will take example of the like West Bengal, if suppose there is a community, Hindu community, sorry, if there is a Hindu community and like they are ready to process their Durga Puja Yatra, and if there is Mohammedan community and they want to like follow their rituals and they want to process their rituals also, and if they are like at the same time and there may be cause of the conflict between the people, our government is not supporting that also. Even government can regulate, yes, on the evening time the Durga Puja can be happen and the morning time that Mohammedan procession can be happen. This type of like regulation government can do and it doesn't the violation of the Article 25. There are two exceptions also in this article, like regulating or restricting any economic, financial and political and other secular activity which may be associated with the religious practice. You might have heard about the Tirumala temple, that we are saying that Balaji temple, Tirupati temple, and TTD, like Tirumala Tirupati Devasthana, TTD is calling that. We are calling it TTD. TTD means Tirumala Tirupati Devasthana. There is our government is regulating by posting any IAS officer to the economic and financial transaction over there. Means government can regulate the if a religious practice that related to the economic, financial and secular activity. Secular activities means there was a concept in the 1994 that Bhims 1990 that Bhim Singh versus State of India, means that case was regarding that, yes, that point of time there was a case in the Supreme Court regarding that how that mosque can be acquired or not. Means there was a concept of the ERP means essential religious practice. Means if our court is not or government is not violating the essential religious practice, then definitely government can regulate the religious practice also, like related to the financial and political, and if people are like accumulating finance on the name of the religion, then government can utilize or can regulate that type of practice. And like even religious reforms comes under this exception, like providing for the social welfare, means reform or the throwing upon the all Hindu religion institution of a public character of all classes and section of Hindu. Means it imposing the restriction also, like if a organization or any institution for the Hindu religion community, and like it is throws on all the public, like all the public, means if a Hindu institution is there like temple, all society of the all the caste of the Hindu religion can utilize and they can process of their religion practice over there. Means anybody can enter the Hindu religion temple and it like impose restriction also religious community. If maybe in the future or in the past there were several instances like people were prohibiting the lower caste to enter the temple and like processing their puja and all things, but right now it also mentioned in the Article 25 that it is the exception, yes, providing for the social welfare. If a social welfare is happening and reform is happening, then a state can control over that. And that Hindu religious institution are throws for the all classes and section of the Hindu. Means This is temples and the all religious institutions are open for the all communities of the Hindu society. Here the given two example are giving like a wearing the kirpan and carrying kirpan is the essential religious practice in the Sikh religion. And but I want to explain you with the help of the cases what happened in the Supreme Court, because mere reading the two lines or three lines is about the article is not sufficient to crack any like a classman job. Then you have to think or you have to refer the all the cases what happened in the past, then only you would able to clarify all your doubts regarding articles. And generally we are finding like so many questions also from the that portion only. Like if I will take example of the that Professor Bhim Singh versus State of Jammu and Kashmir 1990, that was a case where that ERP concept was coming, like priesthood, like in the JNK there was a dispute over the priesthood, means who would be the priest of that church. That is a religious activity and that is even secular function, means it is not comes under the essential religious practice. Means if we are not, our state government is not violating the essential religious practice, then state can interfere and it is a secular activity. That's why that it totally depends upon the government that who would be the priest of that temple or the church, that government can decide also. This is the not essential religious practice of any religion. Thus, if I will like make you understand that what is the essential religious practice. Like if you are chanting or reciting that Hari Om, Hari Om, that is the essential religious practice. Means nobody shall interfere in your religion, that you should chant such type of hymns and the tenets. That is the essential religious practice. But like if you are like doing any discrimination in the society or the gender basis, you might have heard that Sabarimala temple case, there was a discrimination between like for the women that who are menstruating women, and they were not allowing to enter the Sabarimala temple, but Supreme Court clarified what is the essential religious practice and what is the non-essential religious practice, and they declared that yes, women can enter the Sabarimala temple. Even I will further clarify this, that like for your understanding I am telling all the things. Even I have already reiterated that Tirumala Tirupati Devasthana also, that IAS officer is posted and who is managing all the financial transaction over there, because a huge chunk of amount financial transaction is happening in that institution, and there should be like regulation of the government also on that, otherwise it may be like a fatal for the sentiments of the people. If in the future there would be any like corruption would be there, then that can be disheartened for the like who are the very like devoted to the religion. That's why our state also controlling this by posting an IAS over there. And I will take example of the 1954 case, that Sirur Math case. In that case, from that case even like our Supreme Court declared that doctrine of essentiality. This is the case we have to keep in mind, that Sirur Math 1954. From that case we are following the doctrine of essentiality, that essential religious practice. And what is the essential, what is the non-essential? I already told you that like reciting any tenets is the essential religious practice, but where you have to follow, what type of your money is coming from your donation, then how you regulate that is not the essential religious practice, and state can regulate that also. And if I will talk about the Muslim community, then praying 5 times in a day is the essential religious practice. But where you have to pray, that is the not essential religious practice. You can pray at your home also, and you can pray like any mosque also. That totally depends upon the state. State can regulate also. Even that case happened in the Kerala itself, because that point of time, Sirur Math, in the even 1994 there was a case of the Ismail Farooqi versus like state of Union of India. In that case, 1994 Ismail Farooqi case, that case was about the Kerala, because Kerala government want to acquire the land for the road and railway construction, and there was a mosque in between. That so many people were uproaring and they are protesting against the government, but why they are like demolishing the mosque over there. But after that case, like 1954, even like a 1994 Ismail Farooqi case also, that our Supreme Court came up with the pronounced the decision on the basis of the essential religious practice. Even in that 1994 Ismail Farooqi case, that told that mosque is not a essential religious practice. People can like pray at their home also, and if like for the like public welfare, that if a government is any taking an initiative, and that should considerable. But the same case happened in the Sabarimalai temple also, that Lord Ayappa. First of all, I want to tell you what was the case, that Lord Ayappa is a like internal celibate. Celibate means brahmachari, and like for reaching up to that temple, there is a condition. For Lord Ayappa temple, or if a person like a devotee want to visit that Lord Ayappa temple, there is a condition, certain condition, that you have to, if a male person is willing to go there, then he has to take vow for the 41 days, means abstain from the sexual intercourse for the 41 days. After that person can visit to the Lord Ayappa temple between the mountain, and he can like perform all the rituals, or he can do pray in the inner sanctum of the Lord Ayappa temple. This is the condition to visit there. But here there is a clause that if a woman between the age of the 10 to 50, means a menstruating woman, cannot visit the Lord Ayappa inner sanctum temple, because they are considering the Lord Ayappa as a celibate, means brahmachari, and they don't want to be prayed by the women that who are menstruating age. This is the condition, and there was so much uproar, and that case reached up to the Supreme Court, and the Supreme Court gave verdict for that Sabarimala temple, and that was the ratio of the 4:1, means 4 judges were in the favor of the two, like entrance of the ladies to the inner sanctorum of the temple, and one that that is very like awkward situation. One lady was there, and he was Indu Malhotra, and she was like opponent of that verdict, and she was not in the favor of the two visit of the temple by the woman between the age of the 10 to 15. And even the same case, like even triple talaq, that Justice Keher was doing same thing. Just I want to tell you that so all things very like meticulously, so that you can utilize these statements for your mains examination, and even like if you are discussing all the things with your friend, then you can definitely would get edge over the other students or other like your friends and family members if you are discussing in that manner. That I want to tell you what were the like verdict and what were the statement of the judges in that case. Even like CGI Deepak Mishra, that point of time she was like he was the main CGI, and he was like heading the judgment, and Justice Deepak Mishra told in his verdict, and he pronounced that women and men are these children of the same God, means there should be no discrimination between the women and men, because it's we are not promoting the discrimination like untouchability under Article 17, and that is also applicable on the men and women also. Means there should be no discrimination between the men and women on the gender basis. There should be no discrimination. And like a second judge was the Rohitan Nariman, like pronounced in his judgment that yes, there is a biological difference between the men and women, and there should not be discrimination on the biological basis.
it totally like all the peoples are the creation of the God, and we should consider them at par, means all should be equal. And the third judge was the like Dhananjay Chandrachud, and that he pronounced in his judgment that yes, for visiting to the Lord Ayyappa temple, there should be requirement of the 40 days celibation, means like you are taking vow and you would abstain from the sexual intercourse between the 41 days. Yeah, means you are discriminating the woman, or you are like denigrating the woman. They can't abstain from the like 41 days. This is the harsh, like gruesome situation of that case or that verdict. That's why that Justice Dhananjay Chandrachud gave or pronounced in his judgment that we should not denigrate the woman on the basis of that their like gender untouchability. We should not promote the gender untouchability. And like then one lady, that Indu Malhotra, she pronounced in her judgment that yes, there are two concepts. What are the concept? Like religion and the rationality and religion. Rationality means like matter of science. Rationality means matter of science, and we are talking about the objectivity, because we are doing any lab like experiment and we are saying whatever like we are getting and what are the objects we are producing in the lab. That is the matter of the logic, means matter of the rationals. And religion doesn't base on the logic, because generally we are watching on the road, or the people, they are visiting their temples by laying down on the road and covering all the like distance by laying down. And you might have seen that some people are like putting ash on their forehead, and some people are celebrating their religion rituals in different way. That's why like court or the any judge is not qualified to judge the what is the like essential practice, and what should be the rational and what would be the like logic, because they are for the only like judging what are the provision of the legislation according to the like constitution, they are fulfilling the parameters. That is the qualification of a judge or the CGI. But judiciary has no role to interfere in like religion, or judiciary has no role in the religion, or they cannot differentiate the religion and the rationality. And the same like even Hyderabad vice chancellor like Nalsar is a law institute in the Hyderabad, and the vice chancellor of that institute, the same thing like reiterated by the him also, that his name is Faizan Mustafa reiterated the same thing, that we should not, and judiciary is not the competent authority to decide what is the rational and what is the religion, because religion doesn't depend upon the rationality. It totally depends upon the like how people are having faiths and how they are celebrating. It totally depends on, and like essential religious practice is also like not the why like unnecessary judiciary is intervening the essential, or we are following essential religious practice. And if this like I have already told you, and in the case that 1954, that Surur Math case, there was a case, and from that case the essential religious practice concept came into the existence. Like court should not decide that. Even the same like Ismail Farooqi case, that 1994 decided the Supreme Court is no one to interfere that essential religious practice. Why should Supreme Court judge essential religious practice parameter? There was a case in the Kerala, that mosque case, and that was the in between, or that was the hindrance on the railway project, and the Kerala government want to confiscate, or they want to acquire that land for the railway track. On that case we are following the ERP concept. Yes, government can acquire the any land by the usage of the like doctrine of the eminent domain, means for the larger public interest government is doing something, they can like acquire the land for that project. This may be the like one of the solution of that thing, and otherwise like Supreme Court or judiciary is not competent authority to decide what is the wrong and what is the right in their religious, because religious is totally depend upon the faith of the people. If you would ask from me, that is the same, like rationality is different thing and religion is different thing, because we are not following the concept of the rationality in the religion. Sometimes like we are lighting or lighting the like any light in the temple, and what is the logic behind this? Nobody knows. Nobody not knows this type of thing. We should like just following the what we are, our forefathers have done, and the, we should protect and preserve that like tradition also. That's why we are following the norms. And if we are going per as per the rationality, you would find so many like absurd things in the religion, and we should like not go into that deep, like deeply. That is all about the Article 25th, and I think it is very like a very important article, so that we can utilize this statement in the normal conversation and for the preliminary and the mains examination also. Like examination is very important, plays a very pivotal role in our life, but it doesn't mean that you would not clear any examination, you would not get any job anywhere, and you would not recognition. But if you are having knowledge, definitely you would speak in front of any public, then people definitely will regard your hard work and your knowledge. Thanks for watching, and I will come tomorrow with the Article 26. Thanks for watching. Bye.